Part 2. Shreemad Bhagavatham. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Sree Krishna is born. Avathaara. Parikshit inquired of sage Shuka. O gracious sage, hearing the stories of the Supreme Lord destroys the liabilities to rebirth. They are so very pleasing to the ears and they bring such immense peace to the mind that even an ordinary man will never refuse to hear them. How can I resist the urge? Please tell me about the leelas of the Supreme Lord as Sree Krishna. Why did he decide to be born in the dynasty of the Yadavas? Yadu was the son of Yayati. What did he do and how did he live? Please tell me his stories in full. My thirst to hear them is very great. It can be satiated only by your sweet words. Sage Shuka replied, O blessed king, the stories of Lord Vasudeva purify the narrator, the inquirer and the hearer simultaneously. And so I will narrate the same to you with all my devotion. Hearing the stories of the Lord is like wearing precious ornaments for the ears. They are the joy of the learned people. They destroy all the sins of the numberless past births. They augur auspiciousness. And so he continued his narration. Once Mother Earth felt that she was unable to bear the burden of cruel men. She took the form of a cow and approached Brahma for solace. Brahma was powerless to relieve her distress. So he led her to the Supreme Lord Vishnu, praised him with great humility and reported to him the grievance of the earth. The Supreme Lord sympathetically heard her story and decided to do the needful. He directed that all the gods should be born on earth in the clan of the Yadavas, descendants of Yadu. He himself would be born of Devaki and Vasudeva as Sree Krishna. Adisesha would be born as Balarama. Prakriti would be born as Yoga Maya, and she would assist his work in relieving the burden of the earth. Surasena was the king of a small kingdom near Mathura, belonging to the dynasty of Yadavas. His son Vasudeva married Devaki, daughter of Ugrasena, king of Mathura. The wedding was just concluding. The bridal pair were about to start on a gala wedding procession. Devaki's brother Kamsa took a fancy to drive the bridal chariot. No sooner the procession started, a formless voice cried out, O Kamsa, the eighth son of this Devaki, your sister, whom you are now leading with great pleasure, will kill you. Beware. Kamsa, who was most cruel by nature, immediately jumped out of the chariot, took a sword and rushed to kill the bride, Devaki. Vasudeva, the bridegroom, saw the unexpected danger and stood up to interfere. He knew that Kamsa was a very cruel man and that violence would not suit the occasion. So he thought it wise to ward off the imminent danger by some wise device. He explained to Kamsa that the sister was not going to kill him, but her eighth son. The son was not there. Vasudeva appealed to Kamsa saying, I will give you all the sons as and when they are born to Devaki. You can kill them if you want. Do not stoop to kill a helpless girl, your own sister, and get an irrevocable bad name. She's newly married. Though she is your sister, she is like a daughter to you. She is a noble girl and a potential representative of Goddess Lakshmi. She is terror-stricken. Do not try to harm her. Death is certain for everybody that is born. Why should you get the blame for it? Kamsa was moved by these words and abandoned his action. The procession was over. By and by, Devaki brought forth a son every year. Vasudeva used to take one son after another as they were born and offer them to Kamsa. refused to harm them, saying that he would kill only, and Kamsa refused to harm them, saying that he would kill only the eighth one, which was prophesied to be his enemy. One day, sage Narada came there and told Kamsa that he, Kamsa, was the reincarnation of the demon Kalanemi, and that the Yadavas were all incarnations of gods, and the Supreme would be born to Vasudeva to kill him. Hearing this, Kamsa imprisoned Vasudeva and Devaki and killed all the sons that were born to them till then. He dethroned his own father Ugrasena, put him in prison, and himself began to rule the province. It is natural for greedy monarchs to kill their own father, mother, brother, or relations just for the sake of kingdom, because they firmly believe that they would live long. They cannot see death that follows them from behind like a shadow. Kamsa killed all the six sons of Devaki. Meanwhile, Lord Srihari planned every detail for his birth. He directed Prakriti, Yogamaya, to go and transplant the embryo in the womb of Devaki, where Adisesha was thriving, to the womb of Rohini, who was another wife of Vasudeva, but living in Gokula. There, Adisesha was born to Rohini as Balarama. People thought that Devaki had an abortion. Next year, Devaki was again pregnant, and her complexion was extraordinarily bright. By constantly seeing her, Kamsa was reminded of the curse, and so was night and day dreaming of his own death. Thus, he was in constant remembrance of the Lord, though out of fear. When the term of pregnancy of Devaki was complete, Brahma, Shiva, and other gods, Narada and other sages came there and began to praise him, the formless, who was about to take a form, the most charmful form, and play a great drama. Hail to the Lord Supreme, the Infinite. Welcome to the Lord of the Universe. Your resolve is truth. You are truth. You are the treasure house of truth. You exist in truth. Your eyes are truth and righteousness. You are called truth. You are beyond time. You are unaffected by the past, present, and future. We take shelter in you. You are the support for all manifestations. This beginningless tree called manifestation is your Prakriti, matter. This tree bears two fruit called pleasure and pain. It has three roots called sattva, rajas, and tamas. It has four kinds of juices as dharma, artha, kama, and moksha. It has five activities as the perceptions of hearing, touch, sight, taste, and smell. It has six experiences of birth, existence, growth, old age, decay, and death. It has seven components as skin, blood, flesh, fat, bone, marrow, and nervous matter. It has eight sheets as earth, water, fire, wind, space, mind, intellect, and ego. It has nine apertures as two eyes, two ears, two nostrils, mouth, urethra, and anus. It has 10 moving leaves as prana, apana, udana, smana, vyana, naga, kurma, krakara, devadatta, and dhananjaya. Two birds perch upon it called the jiva and ishvara. You are its cause. You are its resting place, and into you it, universe, dissolves. The ignorant look upon you as many. The wise see you as one. Out of your sattva guna, you take many forms for the good of the whole world. The wise seek you as the boat to cross the ocean of samsara. Your grace is overflowing towards them. Those who do not catch hold of your feet for protection fall into the abyss of samsara. Hearing, reciting, contemplating on your sacred name, and by helping others to do so, one escapes rebirth. So please be gracious enough to step down on this earth to make it sacred by your touch and remove the fear of the innocent people that is now existing in the form of Kamsa and other demons. At a very auspicious moment in the middle of the night, when the star Rohini was uppermost, on the eighth day of the dark fortnight of the month of Shravana, in the rainy season, the Supreme Lord was born to Devaki in the prison house. Resplendent in his features, the Lord appeared in his full glory to Devaki and Vasudeva. They both looked and looked at him as much as they could and praised him to their heart's content. We have really seen you with our fleshy eyes. With the, what the sages say that they see you in their samadhi is a mere assertion. Ours is a practical experience, Devaki declared. The Lord instructed Vasudeva as to what he had to do next and then took the form of a newborn baby. So the blue boy of Brindavan was born and the day is even now celebrated as Krishna Janma Ashtami or Sree Jayanti every year. It was dark midnight. There were incessant showers of rain. All the prison gods were fast asleep. Vasudeva took the baby in a basket, covered it well and set out. The chains binding his legs got loose and fell down. The gates of the prison opened themselves. All the servants and guards were sleeping. Vasudeva proceeded towards Gokula, Nanda's Vraja. Adisesha protected the baby from rain with his hoods. River Yamuna, which was in floods, gave way for the Lord to pass on. Vasudeva reached the dwelling of Nanda. Just then, Yogamaya was born at Gokula to Yashoda, wife of Nanda, as a female child, and by her power spread an envelope of sleep on everybody in the village. Yashoda too was fast asleep after the hardships of labor. Vasudeva saw the female baby by the side of Yashoda. He laid the blue boy by her side, took the female baby, put it in his basket and returned to his prison house. He placed the baby by the side of Devaki, put on the chains over his legs and lay down. The baby began to cry aloud. The gods woke up, rubbed their eyes and realized their great neglect due to sleep. They ran to Kamsa and reported the birth of a baby to Devaki. Kamsa was startled by the news, jumped from his bed and thought his death was imminent and sure by the baby. With great anger, he ran towards the confinement room. Seeing him, Devaki stood up and tried to prevent him from taking the baby. Brother, it is a female child, not a male one as prophesied, she said, and so requested him that at least a daughter may be spared to her alive. But Kamsa had no ears to hear her. He pulled the baby by the legs and tried to smash it against the rocky floor as if it were an earthen toy. But to the surprise of all, the baby flew off his hands, rose high up into the sky and transformed itself into a magnificent goddess with 8 hands which were full of different weapons. Her body was beautifully decorated. She was surrounded by celestials who were praising the deity with their sweet voices. Standing in the sky, the goddess Yogamaya addressed Kamsa and said, "O cruel Kamsa, mercilessly you have killed all the young children of Devaki. You are not satisfied. Like a big hero, you try to dash me on the rocky floor, but you have miserably failed. Where is your might gone? I could have punished you and torn you into pieces for your cruel deeds. But since you have caught hold of my legs like a suppliant, I have to pardon you. To punish you, the proper hero is born elsewhere and he will complete that work." Warning him thus, she disappeared. Kamsa got afraid. He was bewildered. He begged pardon of Devaki and Vasudeva. He quoted philosophy. Veda Vina Sinam Nityam Yena Majamavyayam Katham Aspurusha Parthakam Gatayati Hantikam Nainam Chindanti Sastrani Nainam Dahati Pavakaha. We are all tools in the hands of a great controller. I have acted cruelly. Pardon me. He touched their feet and had the chains removed. Vasudeva was much pleased with his words of regret and greeted him warmly. Kamsa went back to bed for the night, but with a confounded mind.